This hydrogen and oxygen generator is a safe, reliable unit for your soldering and casting needs. It uses electricity by utilizing hydrogen and oxygen without using an external tank, creating a safer, cleaner, and more economical fuel. Let's go through how to set up and use this machine. As always, be sure to wear safety glasses and gloves before you get started. Make sure the switch is in the off position. Plug the power cord into the machine and into the electrical outlet, making sure it's the correct voltage. Unscrew the safety cap and leave the booster tank disconnected. Click the button switch down to the fill/refill position, which looks like an equal sign. When the green light is on, it indicates the machine is connected to power. Yellow indicates the internal tank is empty and needs to be filled, or the water level is below normal and more water is needed. Red means the internal tank is at max capacity. We suggest using this pre-mixed electrolyte solution. Pour the solution into the internal tank using a funnel until the red light comes on, indicating the tank is filled and is above the minimal required level. Be sure not to overfill the tank. Close the safety cap. The solution will last 1 year, refilling when needed using demineralized water. For the flux, we suggest using this flux solution. Wearing gloves, pour the solution into the unattached booster tank by placing your finger on the threaded tube in the center of the tank to avoid filling the interior chamber. Fill to the maximum level indicated on the outside of the booster tank. Do not overfill. Once it is filled, mount the booster tank. Carefully tighten the handle, making sure not to cross-thread the booster tank. Unscrew the nut from the booster holder. Insert the plastic hose to the fitting and tighten the nut with a wrench to make the connection secure. After mounting the booster tank and torch, select the green burner tip and push it in place at the end of the torch. Before turning on the machine, set the power knob to 0. Turn on the machine by pushing the switch to the top position, which looks like a minus sign. Adjust the setting for power according to the diameter on the burner tip. After the machine is on for a couple of minutes, gas will begin discharging from the burner tip. You can now light the flame. Keep in mind that if you don't follow the suggested settings for each burner tip, it could melt or fuse. You can now use the torch. To shut off the flame, push the torch hose fitting, then turn the power control knob to 0, then turn off the power switch. Always shut the flame off before turning the machine off. Leave the internal tank pressurized when your work is done. Remember, yellow light will indicate low water levels. Before refilling the internal tank, remember to detach the booster tank to avoid contamination. Once removed, fill the internal tank with demineralized water until the red light comes on. If needed, add flux solution to the booster tank, covering the threaded pipe with your finger until it reaches the max fill line. Secure both tanks before continuing. If you aren't using the machine for a few days, unscrew and pour the flux from the booster tank into a clean, covered container for future use. Get your ET torch today at stala.com/tools.